You ready? You ready?
This fight is brought to you by Yahoo Philippines. Docyogen in the red trunks.
Docyogen goes right away for that side kick. It looks like he's going to try to test his stand up here before he.
Urushitani in the red and white.
Low kicked overhand right just misses by Docyogen.
Feeling each other out for the moment with the distance testing kicks.
Rey's got that very sideways striker stance where he makes his body narrow, minimizes that target, and that usually sets up a lot of kicks. You tell a lot by the way a guy stands. Wrestlers tend to have one position. Strikers tend to stand in another. Guys, they like to throw a lot of kicks. Stylistically, some varying factors.
Very bouncy, isn't he, Docyogen?
He's a bouncy fellow.
So far, not much that's been damaging from either fighter. Lots of kicks to the leg. Punches falling, by and large, short.
Good leg kick by Docyogen.
Oh,
nice head kick.
That did look good. Followed up with a right hand that was just short.
Nice leg kick on the inside, too.
Starting to stamp his authority, the Filipino. Oh, that leg kick was high in the sense that it was almost illegal.
In on a double leg now.
Urushitani with a good knee to the midriff of the Filipino fighter there.
Nice side kick. He telegraphs that side kick a little when he starts to bounce and drop his left hand. You see he's setting that up.
Oh!
Trims the eyebrows. The nice head kick there.
Right on the forehead, wasn't it? Solid, landed solidly. Wasn't much that was brushing or glancing in nature there. And that was solid to the midriff as well. Good work with the feet.
Rey really working on that side kick. Kind of has that Bruce Lee stance a little bit. He has that left hand down, right hand up by his face.
Well, that can't be a bad thing.
No, from what I've heard, Bruce Lee was a pretty tough dude.
He was pretty good.
Yeah, pretty good.
Cuffing.
A couple of good punches there.
Yeah, cuffing right hand.
You know, Bruce Lee was actually one of the first mixed martial artists before his death. He was training with Judo Jean LaBelle and starting to open up his arsenal and saw the ability of grapplers to really take over in the mixed martial arts sport world.
Good right hand uppercut from Docyogen on the inside there, and he certainly is piling up the points in this opening 5 minutes.
This far, I'd have to give it to Rey. I think he's really done a good job of setting up some of those punches. You know, is it just me?
Left hand.
Or does Rey look a little bit like a Manny Pacquiao from some angles?
Yeah, there's some similarities there for sure. I think Manny would be fairly proud of one or two of these punches that Rey's thrown as well.
Well, the Filipino pride runs deep, especially in the fighting breed. You know, Rey's had a lot of success with that side kick and those inside leg kicks, and then just threw a haymaker from right field.
He nearly hit me with that. Tremendous speed.
Another right hand.
Gets caught. Yeah, got caught by the Japanese fighter who then ushered his opponent in for a little bit more. Final 10 seconds of this round.
Rey's got great footwork too. He's moving really well, staying on the balls of his feet.
Just got caught with a left hand and then a knee to the head as well. Good work from the Japanese fighter in the dying seconds, but I would think that Docyogen slightly ahead after those first 5 minutes.
I concur. It's been a great fight so far, and you see Rey here ducks a couple of punches and then was able to defend the one takedown that was attempted in the round. Does a good job of staying light on his feet and launching head kicks all the way from Cape Canaveral. NASA style, right to the outer space, into your orbit. Bam, on the leg, but follow up right hand, right to the chin. You know the best way to counter a kick? Big overhand right.
Certainly threatened the prospects of that happening tonight.
Good leg kick by Yasuhiro. All of the Team Lakai fighters have really impressed me with their wrestling ability and their anti-wrestling ability, being able to stop those takedowns and play to their strengths. Nice head kick, nice body kick. Kick, but man, you can tell that Docyogen is looking for the knockout here.
Yasuhiro walked right into that one as well. Shows a good chin there.
Good timing, very nice pacing by Docyogen, and good leg kick.
Punishing leg kick, wasn't it?
This is a big step up in competition for Docyogen too. This is a two-time UFC vet that he's fighting, and he's doing a very good job. The tie plum clinch.
Throwing leather, these two.
The coolest referee in all of MMA, telling him not to grab the shorts. Just misses with that right hand on the break.
Once again, Docyogen is impressive. He got caught there. Very nice counter.
A head kick. Working on the guillotine choke now. Let's see if Docyogen has a very solid defense here. It looks like he's doing the right thing. He's got his hands on the arm that's choking him. Action's right in front of us here. Yasuhiro in on a front headlock.
Bringing the knee up constantly there, but Rey escapes.
And Rey did the smart thing too. He broke free and he circled out of where the danger was. A lot of guys break free and they try to just throw punches back. They feel like they need to get back at their opponent. And they start fighting from an emotional standpoint, not an intellectual one, but Ray's showing a lot of ring savvy here.
The inside of Yasuhiro's right thigh must be very sore because he's taking some brutal punishment.
And you don't often see fighters move up in a weight class, but like you mentioned earlier, the URCC pinweight champion, 119 pounds, coming up in weight to fight competition. Previously 10-0 in his career, looking very sharp in the striking department, and against a guy who's a two-time UFC veteran.
Oh my, the eyebrows nearly got taken off there. There's that kick to the inside of the Japanese fighter's right thigh. He may well be limping tomorrow morning.
And this is an interesting stylistic matchup also, because Yasuhiro is known as a counter striker and has a very slick submission game. Hasn't been able to get that going yet. And so far, Docyogen just really dominating the stand-up. Nice duck under, good footwork. You know, that's what's nice about seeing guys that have high-level striking, is they have good footwork and that bouncing and keeping off of the heel of your feet enables you to move and cut those angles. Nice head kick.
This is impressive from Rey Docyogen.
Oh, what's for dinner? It's a right hand.
Final minute of this second round. A And the Japanese fighter, to me, looks a little bit frustrated.
Nice body shot. You know, Ray's doing a thing that Chuck Liddell was very, very, very good at. Counter-striking and backing up. Usually you don't see aggressive strikers backing up and throwing punches, but Docyogen has been doing that. Even though Yasuhiro has been moving forward the whole time, Docyogen has been really landing more of the aggressive strikes.
Docyogen is really throwing, really throwing. Not always landing, but he's going for the big ones.
Side kick to an inside thigh kick.
Oh, and there's a chase going on. Final 10 seconds of an action-packed round.
It's a great fight so far.
Team Lakai fighters all have such strong legs. You look at all of them.
And here's a nice fake there by Yasuhiro. And then an overhand right caught a little bit on the forearm. Docyogen ate a knee against the cage and then a left elbow over the top. But I'm not sure that's enough to sneak ahead on the judges' scorecards. And just to be sure of that, Docyogen, for good measure, launches a head kick, ducks under that nice right hook, and has done a great job of staying mobile on his feet.
Constantly threatened for this fight to be finished quickly. Big, big punches being thrown.
Well, Yasuhiro,
good
in
right
my opinion, is following, is a little bit behind on the scorecards and needs to really kind of get in there. Start letting his hands go, or maybe look for the takedown. He's been so far content with a stand-up battle, which is a little surprising.
Yeah, it is.
Shot that one takedown, got stuffed like a Thanksgiving turkey. Decided, you know what, maybe this isn't the best route. Let me see if I can counterpunch. Hasn't been that successful there. Docyogen with those nice side kicks. You know, it's funny, you don't see that a lot in MMA, and that's hard to find someone who can emulate that style of striking.
Docyogen has really been very impressive tonight. Reminds me a great deal of Kevin Belingon, actually. Very, very fluid in his attacks from his fists and his feet, showing all-round attack. Exceptional striking.
And good footwork, too. Good lateral movement from Docyogen. Ducking under those punches twice, and just slipped a little bit there. 3 minutes and 45 seconds left for Yasuhiro to show us why he was the former Shooto Bantamweight champion.
The onus is on him, isn't it? To chase down his opponent because he must be behind on points.
Man, cardio for days from the Team Lakai fighters, huh?
Absolutely, yeah.
I jog from here to the restroom and I'm gassed. Fantastic conditioning. You know, that's one of the things that I think really sets MMA apart from other sports. Tried to play Spider-Man and climb the cage there. It's just the incredible conditioning of our athletes.
I think we used the word bouncy, didn't we, at the beginning of the fight, and he remains bouncy even as we get to the final minutes of this fight. Docyogen has blood coming down from his nose. That's probably too little too late in terms of encouragement for the Japanese fighter.
Well, Docyogen's doing a good job of moving. I mean, that movement,
yeah, that's not so great, but look at the state of his face, though, Jason. That nose is pouring blood. I fancy it's broken. Yuji Shimada wants the doctor to see this, and wouldn't this be dreadful if it stopped because of this? I can't think that it will be.
Yeah, no, I don't think that that's going to be stopped. I mean, broken noses are kind of one of the aspects of the sport.
Occupational hazard.
Exactly. It's an OSHA issue. So, you know, you have to look at some of the bigger pictures. They're just going to stop the bleeding a little bit. Double check fighter safety is always important. And one of the things that you never want to see, especially if you're a fighter who I think in this case, Docyogen is winning the fight, you never want to have the fight get stopped and then all of a sudden your opponent wins. But, you know, if the fight gets stopped this far in, I believe it goes to a judge's decision anyway. So wouldn't be the end of the world, but I'm sure that Docyogen...
You fancy it would be Ray's fight in that situation,
right.
Certainly. Actually, I'm just looking at that nose. Can't quite get a good view of it from here, but it could be cut on the outside of the nose rather than in it.
No, I think it's bleeding from inside of it. I think it was a left hook that landed on the butt.
Matt Hume is in there. It does seem as if the nose is bleeding from the inside, Jason.
No. Oh, it's definitely broken.
Yeah, well.
Looks even more like Manny Pacquiao now.
He does. He does have blood on the outside. Or is that just shading? Anyway, he's in trouble one way or the other.
Well, that's one of the interesting things, and I can speak from experience on having a broken nose in a fight.
You can?
Unfortunately, I can. Thiago Alves broke my nose in about 300 places, but you know, the blood starts to drip down the back of your throat, and it creates an issue with your breathing as well. Having those mouthpieces in can disrupt it. You know, sometimes you see fighters, when they get tired, they'll spit their mouthpiece out. Not the case here with Docyogen. He is ready to get in there.
Oh, my! I think we should have a few more stoppages if it starts like this.
You know, Filipino pride on the line for Docyogen. He is not going to let this Japanese judo champion take away the fight from him. 2 minutes and 20 seconds left, and he is on full court press.
It has to be that way. It has to be. He must be behind on points. If you look at the two faces, you'd think that it's Yasuhiro who's ahead, but I can't think that he is. And I think Docyogen will, run for all he's worth in these final 2 minutes now.
Well, he's backpedaling this whole fight since the get-go, but, you know, he's still landed most of the strikes. He's been able to time those well. He stuffed the one shot by Yasuhiro. Now, most of the damage, though, up to this point, has been Yasuhiro with that broken nose on Docyogen. But is that going to be enough in the judges' eyes to make this a victory? I don't think so.
Yet another tremendously entertaining fight.
Two warriors.
It would be nice for this crowd in Manila to have a victory to cheer. Precious few so far for them this evening.
Oh. If Docyogen wins here, he has the potential for a title shot in Hong Kong. Good body kick by Yasuhiro.
Got in trouble there. Yeah, I mean, that's very much in line. A victory here for him, I think, would certainly put him in that position. Oh, big overhand right that I think landed only on his opponent's shoulder.
Docyogen's running away a little bit. Got to be careful, because
it's been a bit too much of that, hasn't there?
You know, you can get that yellow card, you get 10% deducted from your purse, and then suddenly running becomes a costly endeavor. I ran a few times, didn't care for it much.
Final half minute of this round.
How do you see this fight so far, Steve?
I've got to give it to Ray, and I think there'll be 20,000 people behind me and around us. We probably see it the same way.
I think so. You know, I see. Even though Yasuhiro has been moving forward the whole time and chasing Ray down to some capacity, Ray really has picked apart his fight. This reminds me a lot of when Carlo Prater fought, and you know, he backed up and won a fight, even though he was on his heels the whole time. It's going to be interesting to see how the judges score this.
Well, Urushitani was getting a little bit annoyed towards the end there. He knew that he had to get involved, and he couldn't because Ray was doing a runner.
Well, you know, there was one nice kick, and I think there we saw it. That may have broken Docyogen's nose. Yasuhiro comes up with that left kick, lands right on the kisser. I think that's where we saw the blood come from. If we look at that from another angle, we get a couple of nice overhand rights landing on the ear. Good exchanges. Nice right hook. Both Yasuhiro and Docyogen standing in the pocket, throwing heavy leather.
What an entertaining fight that was, though. As we look at the very beautiful Christine Helloa, away from the camera, the not-so-beautiful nose of Rey Docyogen is getting some attention. No big shakes, I imagine. All will be compensated, of course, if his arm gets raised by Yuji Shimada in the next few seconds.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards. Judge number one sees it for Rey Docyogen. Judge number two sees it for Yasuhiro Urushitani. And judge number three sees it for your winner via split decision. From the blue corner, Yasuhiro Urushitani!
Well, I must say, I find that a little bit surprising.